novel about a young woman who is getting married. She's from a very traditional family. She's getting married into a very different, a very modern Indian family. So her relationship is a reflection of the clash of the new and the old that I find in India today, which is at once exciting, but also challenging. It's how the old and new are clashing. Mm-hmm. It's a challenge. So she's going to get married. She's going to discover a family secret that her grandfather kept from her, which is going to change her life, her concept of who she is. And then she's going to leave her home where she's lived all her life, and she's going to go to America on a search. So this is also a novel about the hero's journey, that mythic structure, except it's a female hero this time, and she leaves her man behind and she goes on a search for herself. So about living in a global world, how do you live with difference? Because it takes place in 2002 in the shadow of 9/11. It takes place with, in 2002 with the Godhra riots going on. So it's about learning love and tolerance in a world that is very different. One of the things that I really wanted to point out, which is why I wanted to set it in 2002, is that this is a problem that occurs everywhere. Mm-hmm. We can't say it's an American problem. We can't say mm-hmm. it's an Indian problem. It's a global problem. We live in a global society with multicultural elements. The fear of the other is something we have to own up to. It happens everywhere. But it's really important to know what to do about it. Okay? To know how to live with each other in love and friendship, in spite of otherness. And that's, I think, one of the things I was really thinking of as I was writing Oleander Girl. It was the immigrant experience coming to America, but I'm also now interested in the movement in the other direction, because as you know, there's a lot of movement back to India. Sometimes it's the same people returning, sometimes it's the second generation mm-hmm. trying to find a connection. So I'm really interested in moving back and forth, the different reasons for which people come here. In one amazing thing, it's why do people want to go to India? It's full of characters, they're all wanting to go to India. So I think I'm really examining a lot of different things. And then I've gone back into the past with novels like Palace of Illusion. I love teaching. You know, it's so wonderful. I learn as I teach, and I love being in touch with young writers and people who are, you know, starting off. I think we have so much to learn from each other. I encourage people, if they have a story to tell, they must tell it, and they must try. Unless you try, you don't know what's going to happen. There's so many talented South Asian writers writing now mm-hmm. in America. There's a lot of creative talent. All their stories are different because we all approach the world differently, right? So there's so many voices, so many stories. It's very exciting. There's some wonderful stuff. There's some genre stuff also coming, right? People who are writing crime novels, mm-hmm. writing mystery stories, and that's fine. They're writing chick lit. Why not? But I think it's exciting. I think what's happening in India that's really exciting is that there's a huge growth in the reading public. It's waning here. Publishers here are having lots of problems publishing in India. It's really becoming very popular. I have colleagues who are thinking that that's the way to go. It's before, when we did self-publishing, it was considered not okay. But now self-publishing is really being accepted very well. Even I'm thinking, I have a novel that I've just got the rights back for, an American novel. Mm-hmm. Victory Song, which did very well, but then it went out of print, and now we've got the rights back, and I'm seriously thinking that maybe self-publishing is the way to go. I think it depends on how much the writer knows, because you don't have to live in a culture every day to know. Sometimes when you're visiting a culture, as long as you have contact with that culture, you see things that people that live there don't see it, because you have a fresher vision. So it really depends on how well people can evoke that culture. I think sometimes when you don't live in a culture, you're just aware of things. You can see this in many countries. You know, expatriate writers sometimes write very powerfully about a culture. It all depends. Sometimes writers do write with an agenda. I hope that in my books I show positives and negatives of both cultures. I mean, I would certainly say that my writing about America isn't a simple, how wonderful is America. I'm showing the challenges that the Indian community in America is facing. And when I look at India, I look at the good and the bad. At least that's my hope. That's my enterprise.